Hi, my name is Jack Panopoulos, and I'm an application scientist for Flojo. Today, we're going to be talking about how to copy gates to a group and how to edit existing gates that have been copied to a group, and also how to delete a gate that's been copied to a group, as well as synchronizing your gates. So it's all gate-focused in this short video tutorial. Okay, in the workspace here, I have a series of test files, and I have a series of gates underneath one of those files. The hierarchy is shown, highlighted in gray. And what I would like to do is I want to copy this information to the rest of the files that I have in the workspace. The way to do this, in my opinion, the fastest, easiest way to do this, and the tool of choice, is to go ahead and right-click on the highlighted gates, go down to the option that says copy analysis to group here. The command shift G is a very good tool for this purpose. You go ahead and say copy analysis to group, and that will copy those gates to the group that we're working in this case, the experiment group. And then from here, you will notice that all of the gates now underneath each of the files are having that blue color. Okay, if you made a mistake in a gate, let's say we want to change the position of the CD4 gate. Generally speaking, you have to go to the parental population here, the third quadrant, and you will see your CD4 gate here as well as your CD8 gate. If I want to come in and move this guy over, or perhaps, you know, change the shape of the gate, stretch it out, move a vertex, whatever, you will notice that you can do this in the graph window, and the minute you do that, the font color will change from the blue, in this case the group color that it's associated with, to this sort of flat black font type. So this tells you that this gate's position and or shape has changed relative to its neighbors. And in fact, if we go through and click on the little green arrow here, you'll notice that all the other files have the same shape. It's just that first file that we modified has a kind of elongated rectangle. If we want to update the rest of the files so that they have this gate instead of the initial gate, what we need to do here is highlight that new CD4 gate, the one that's in the black plain type font, highlight it, and then right-click on it and say copy analysis to group. And this will go ahead and update the workspace so that all files now have that elongated shape. Okay? If I go to this sample and I say, okay, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and shrink that back down. It doesn't need to be so long, etc. If I find that particular population, generally indicated by the blue diamond here, you'll notice there again is the CD4 that's kind of in that black, plain black font type. Now, if this gate, you want it to revert to how it was before, rather than updating it for everything else, you highlight the gate and then you want to hit the delete key. Normally, you'll get a prompt that asks you if you want to delete the gate, but because it has been copied to the group already, it can no longer be deleted from the lower section here. And as you can see, the minute I hit the delete key, it snapped that gate back to the original size. And just to show you this again, kind of using an extreme example, I'm moving that gate off into another position. I'm going to shrink it down. You can see there are 0% of cells in that particular gate as well. We come over here, we highlight this, and then we hit the delete key, and you see that that gate snaps back into its original position and size. And then, of course, the color here is restored. You can also, instead of updating the hierarchy kind of one by one or, you know, with your selected gates, you can actually synchronize the gates so that if you make a change in one, it automatically happens for all others. You can synchronize the gates by double-clicking on the group you're working in. This will only work in groups that are not the all samples group. So you may need to create a group first in order to be able to perform this function. Go ahead and double click on the group. This will bring you to the modify group menu. In this particular menu, you'll notice at the top here, there's an option for live group as well as synchronized. Tick the synchronized option and then say apply changes. Close the window, and now when you go about moving your CD4 gate, this will automatically be updated across all other samples. Same thing if you reshape the gate, all other samples will automatically update. So it's entirely up to you if you'd like to use that function or just simply use the copy analysis to group every time you make a change to a gate. I'm going to go ahead and take that synchronization option off, and I'm going to show you one last thing in today's video here. If you want to delete a gate from the hierarchy, you can no longer delete it from the lower section if it has been copied to the group. So in order to get rid of a particular gate, again, if we focus on the CD4 gate here, you must delete the CD4 gate from the groups pane, which is this middle pane in the middle of your screen. So we select the CD4 gate here, then we hit the delete key. You will get an option here to delete it altogether. Leave it on the first sample or leave it on all samples except delete it from the group. Now, generally speaking, when we want to get rid of a gate, we want to get rid of a gate altogether. So I'm going to click the button here where it says delete entirely, and this will remove it from the hierarchy as well as in the graph window. Okay, that completes our copying gates to the group, synchronizing and deleting or editing an existing gate. Please join us later for other videos related to the FlowJo workspace and manipulating your gates or files. Thank you.